Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss about chemical properties of monosaccharide, and under this chemical property first I will discuss about the mutual rotation in monosaccharides, then I will discuss about other chemical properties of monosaccharides like esterification in monosaccharide or glycosidic formation in monosaccharide, etc. So this video is part B of chemical nature of monosaccharide. So to understand mutual rotation, first we have to understand the cyclic structure of monosaccharide. So to explain this cyclic structure of monosaccharide, first I will draw the structure of glucose, then I will explain how cyclic structure will be formed from that glucose. So this is the structure of D-glucose, and glucose forms a stable hemiacetal between this CHO group and this OH group, which is present in the fifth carbon. So first I will explain the mechanism of this reaction, because monosaccharide contains either aldehyde group or ketone group. If it contains aldehyde group, then known as aldose. If it contains ketone group, then it is known as ketose. And in both condition it contains carbonyl group like this. So both type of monosaccharide, which are aldose and ketose, contains this carbonyl group, and when this carbonyl group will react with alcoholic group present in that particular monosaccharide, then reaction will be like this. So in this reaction, carbonyl group is electrophile and this alcoholic group is nucleophile. So this oxygen will withdraw the electrons from this double bond and it will be negatively charged. Then this carbon will react with this alcoholic group and it will form a bond like this. And when rearrangement takes place, then this hydrogen will be transferred to this oxygen, and this negative and positive charge will be neutralized, and ultimately it will form a stable structure like this. So in this structure, formation of a bond takes place between this carbon and this oxygen, and if here we are taking carbonyl group from aldehyde, then it is known as hemiacetal. If this group is coming from ketone, then it is known as hemiketal. Now coming to the structure of D-glucose. So this is the structure of D-glucose, and according to this mechanism, this carbon will form a bond with this OH group. So ultimately this carbon is reacting with OH group, which is present in the most distant asymmetrical carbon like this. And hydrogen present in this OH group will be transferred to this oxygen like this. So ultimately this D-glucose will form a cyclic hemiacetal, and structure will be like this. So this open chain D-glucose will form two types of structure. One is alpha D-glucose and one is beta D-glucose. What is difference between alpha D-glucose and beta D-glucose? Difference is that in alpha D-glucose, this OH group is present in the right side, and here in beta D-glucose, OH group is present in the left side, because earlier this carbon was not an asymmetrical carbon. Now it is asymmetrical carbon, and it is known as enomeric carbon, and here also it is known as enomeric carbon. It means now this carbon contains four different groups. Earlier it was not having four different groups, that is why it is known as enomeric carbon, or sometimes it is also considered as hemiacetal carbon. After formation of hemiacetal, this open chain glucose will be converted into alpha D glucose and beta D glucose, and both these glucose are cyclic in nature, and this cyclic structure is hexagonal, which contains 5 carbon and 1 oxygen on its structure, and it can be represented like this. So if we are talking about this alpha D glucose, then this oxygen is present here and this carbon is present here because it is first carbon. So all groups which are present in the right side will be represented here in the lower side, and all groups which are present in the left side will be represented in the above side of this hexagonal structure. So this OH group will be present here. This H group will be present here. Similarly, this OH group will present below. This H will present above. Again, this H will present below. Then this OH group will present above. Then again, this OH group will present below. This H group will present above. And here this CH2OH group will always present in the upper side, and this H group will always present in the lower side. Similarly, I am writing the structure of this beta D glucose. Here H is present in the right side, so it will present below. This OH group is present in the left side, so it will be written in the upside. OH group is present in the right side, then it will be present below. This hydrogen will present above. Again, this hydrogen will present below. This OH group will present above. This OH group will present below. This H group will present above. And here always this CH2OH will be present above. And always this hydrogen will present below. So these are the cyclic structure of alpha D glucose and beta D glucose. And what is difference between this alpha D glucose and beta D glucose? Difference is these groups. In alpha D glucose, OH group is present in the right side, while in beta D glucose, OH group is present in the left side. Similarly, here H is present above, and here H is present below. So difference is this one only. If we will carefully observe this structure, then in beta D glucose, one OH group is present upside, means heavy group is present upside, then one in downside, then upside, then downside, then upside. But in alpha D glucose, you can see that OH group is present in downside, then again downside, then upside, downside, upside. Means there is alternative up and down heavy groups will be present. If one up and one down heavy group will be present, then there will be no repulsion and the compound will be more stable. That is why this beta D glucose is more stable as compared to alpha D glucose, because here two OH groups are present in same direction, That is why they will show repulsion and it is less stable as compared to this beta D glucose. Now coming to the actual topic of this video, which is mutant rotation in monosaccharide. If we are talking about this D glucose, then if we are having alpha D glucose and we are dissolving that alpha D glucose in the water, then some part of this alpha D glucose will convert in the form of beta D glucose through the acyclic structure and it will achieve the equilibrium. And if we are taking beta D glucose, then some part of beta D glucose will convert into alpha D glucose through the acyclic structure of this D glucose, and again it will achieve the equilibrium. So specific rotation for this alpha D glucose is 112.2 degree and a specific rotation for this beta D glucose is 18.7 degree, and when it will achieve the equilibrium, then specific rotation will be 52.4 degree. And if we are dissolving this alpha D glucose, then it will convert in the form of beta D glucose through this acyclic structure, and the percentage of this alpha D glucose will be approximately 36%. Percentage of this beta D glucose will be 64% approximately, and the percentage of this acyclic glucose will be very less, which is around 0.01%. So if we are having 100% alpha D glucose in our solution, so through this acyclic structure, 64% of alpha D glucose will convert in the form of beta D glucose. And in reverse condition, if we are having 100% beta D glucose in our solution, then through this acyclic structure, 36% will be converted into alpha D glucose, and it will achieve the equilibrium. Means at the equilibrium in the solution, we will have 36% of alpha D glucose, 64% of beta D glucose, and a very very less amount of this D glucose, that is approximately 0.01%. So at the equilibrium, we will get 52.4 degree from combination of this alpha D glucose and beta D glucose, and the calculation for this 52.4 degree will be like this. So in this calculation, we are taking 36% of 112.2 degree and 64% of 18.7 degree. So ultimately it will be 40.392 plus 11.968 degree. So by adding both this, we will get 52.36, which is approximately 52.4 degree. So here question arises, why this alpha D glucose is 36% and beta D glucose is 60%. Here I have written alpha D glucose is less stable as compared to beta D glucose because presence of both these OH group in the same direction. That is why more stable compound will be present in higher percentage. That is why beta D glucose is present in higher percentage as compared to alpha D glucose. So this is the complete concept about mutant rotation, and the compounds which are cyclic in nature will only give the mutant rotation. So other monosaccharides will also form the cyclic structure. For example, fructose. Fructose will also form the cyclic structure, and that is 5-membered ring, which is known as furanose. And furanose ring contains 4 carbon and 1 oxygen. Here this is known as pyranose ring. This pyranose ring contains 1 oxygen and 5 carbon. So these are the details about cyclic structure, hemiacetal, hemiketal and mutual rotation in monosaccharides. In my next video, I will discuss about other chemical properties of monosaccharides. Thank you.